is there wherever you may go, wherever life may lead you. With all my heart, I'll be there too. And from this moment on, I want you to know I let nothing come between us, and I will love the ones you love. Now gonna roll my questions about why, and I've never been so sure of anything in my life.
I wonder what God was thinking He created you. I wonder if He knew everything I would need, because He made all my dreams come true.
Winter snow is falling down, children laughing all around. Are turning on like a fairy tale come true. Sitting by the fire we made, you're the answer when I prayed I would find someone, and baby I found you. And all I want is to hold you forever, and all I need
Who's getting Ashley to be married to Alex? May be seated.
Well, Alex and Ashley, the moment has arrived. The marriage vows that you pledge to each other are beautiful and solemn words. They will certainly take on a much clearer and deeper meaning in the coming days. Each word, each phrase will increase in meaning and experience as you journey together. And you will need to protect and preserve the love that is evident here today by honoring those vows. Your love should not have to increase, but you must always guard it so that it will never decrease. Your love should expand itself in every circumstance and situation of life, and in doing so, it will remain strong and resilient throughout your marriage. If you want to make your future the best and happiest for yourselves and those around you, then you need to follow a few simple steps. Follow them often, every day of your life together. You must recognize how and when to apply these steps, and they will sustain you in building a strong relationship. I would like to go over these five steps with you. Start each day and end each day by telling each other, "I love you." It may not always be spoken words, but words of your heart and spirit, your actions, or simply the attitude you give forth. It will express to each other that your love and desire is still strong and steady. The deepest expression of your love is revealed in some simple words or actions that say you care more about how you make them feel than how they make you feel. Those actions will speak clearly. You are the most important person in my life. The bond of love that brought you together will be tested over time, but never allow anyone or anything to break the strong and lasting relationship that is bound together with these simple words, "I love you, always and forever." If you want to keep a strong marriage in your relationship, and I believe that you do, start each day with forgiveness. And you heard me correctly, just simple forgiveness. It means that you individually put yesterday's hurts, disappointments, disagreements, and tensions aside. As the Bible reads, "Let not the sun go down on your wrath." Don't hold on to things that will put a strain on your marriage. I realize that each day will not and should not be filled with conflict or emotional ups and downs, but follow this simple principle of forgiveness. And when those things and times do come, it will preserve a strong and meaningful relationship. Communicate often and freely with understanding, compassion, and above all, that forgiveness. If you want to have a happy and fulfilling life together, learn the meaning of respect. Keep a respectful attitude and disposition for each other and continue to do so every day in your marriage. Each of you has a God-given role in marriage. You must engage yourself to diligently fulfill that role with respect and honor for each other. You must work together and not separately, knowing that each has their individual strengths and weaknesses. The overall effect will be to increase the strong bond of love and oneness, knowing that it takes both of you working together to make your marriage complete. If you want to have a rewarding journey together, share in life's moments, life's important moments, decisions, and never keep secrets. One of the greatest enemies in marriage is mistrust. It will weaken the bond of marriage and insulate you from each other. Learn to trust one another's judgment and ability. Learn a good balance of strengths and weaknesses and respect them throughout your married life. There will be many good decisions and there will be a few bad decisions along the way, but those are the times that build character and resilience in your marriage. Trust one another completely without question, and it will mold peace and confidence in your marriage relationship. Finally, if you want to have a long and enduring relationship, keep your love for God first place in each of your lives. Your marriage relationship should be, it should mirror your love and your deep relationship you have with God and with His church. Always be an individual and in following God, but never become independent in your relationship with God or each other. And I say to you both, may God bless you in your marriage as you begin a wonderful and beautiful journey together.
Gathered here in the sight of God and in the face of this company to join together Alex and Ashley in holy matrimony, which is an honorable state instituted of God, signifying to us the mystical union between Jesus Christ and His church, which holy estate Jesus Christ adorned and beautified with His presence in the first miracle that He wrought in Cana of Galilee, and is commanded of the apostle to be honorable among all, and therefore is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, and soberly in the fear of God. Into this holy estate, Alex and Ashley come now to be joined. If anyone may show just cause why they may not lawfully be joined together, let them now speak, or else forever hold your peace. Alex, Ashley, I require and charge you both, as you will answer in the dreadful day of judgment, when the secrets of all hearts shall be disclosed, that if either of you know any reason why you may not lawfully be joined together in matrimony, you do now confess it. For be ye well assured that if any persons are joined together other than as God's word doth allow, their marriage is not lawful. If ye then, Alex and Ashley, have freely and deliberately chosen each other as partners in this holy estate, and know no just cause why you should not be so united, in token thereof, will you please join your right hands? Robert Alexander Caldwell IV, do you promise to take Ashley to be thy wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy state of matrimony? Do you promise to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto her so long as you both shall live? Ashley Page Brand, do you promise to take Alex to be thy wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy state of matrimony? Do you promise to love him, comfort him, honor and obey him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto him so long as you both shall live? Then are you devoted to each other until death alone shall part you. I, Alex Caldwell, take thee, Ashley Brand, to be my wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part, according to God's holy ordinance, and thereto I pledge thee my love. I, Ashley Brand, take thee, Alex Caldwell, to be my wedded husband, to have and hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to obey, till death do us part, according to God's holy ordinance, and thereto I pledge thee my love. For as much as Alex Caldwell and Ashley Brand have covenanted together in holy wedlock, in accordance with the teachings of the Holy Scriptures and the laws of this state, and have witnessed the same before God and his company, and thereto have given and pledged their love to each other, I, as an officer of the law and a minister of the gospel, do pronounce that they are husband and wife. Recalling the eternal commandment of Jesus Christ in Matthew 19, what therefore God hath joined together, let not man put asunder. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for your blessings, we thank you for your goodness, we thank you for Brother Alex and Sister Ashley, and we do pray that you continue to bless their union. We ask that you bless their home and help them as they go. We pray that you be with them in their travels and with each thing that they do. We pray that you help them to always seek after you and keep you first. And we do pray that you continue to bring good things to their lives. We do pray that you administer each one here and ask that you go with us through the day and continue to be good to us. And we thank you for it. In Jesus' name, amen.
Wonder what God was thinking when he created. Everything I would need, because he made all my dreams come true. When God made you, he must have been thinking about me.
Friends, I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Alex Caldwell.